you lost your mind? Michelle, what are you talking about? Michelle, don't you dare hang up on me. I don't care that you're in a rush and you're busy. No, it doesn't work that way, m'lady. You cannot drop a bombshell like that and then say ta-ra. Where are you going anyway? Michelle. Michelle. Oh, don't you dare.
Okay, look. For your information, I have no wish to feature in your nasty little rag. I have integrity, right? So you can take your limelight and shove it. Unbelievable. He asked me if I was photogenic. You are? Some slimy reporter wanting an enlightened provincial source. Creep. He's after the lowdown on Heston. Wants to know if there isn't a sexual angle. Better not be him again.
Okay, do me a favour. That's my mum. Don't see me, all right?
Good morning, campus surgery. Hi, Vera. No, haven't seen her. Don't think she's due in here today, as far as I know.
The plumber said I can save your wife, but the rabbis are gone.
What's this? Do you think we really need negative publicity right now?
Well, I suppose I should be calling on that well-worn axiom that there's no such thing as bad publicity.
Don't you spout your spurious rubbish at me.
Spurious, really?
Yes, really. Page 5.
I mean, I have a right to sound beliefs about tawdry so-called medical practices. It was a private consultation. That Mrs. Davies is a conniving harpy who deliberately engineered...
And page 7. And Ruth has been asked questions by a Red Top reporter whether you ever practice sexual malfunctions. A Red Top.
This is outrageous.
A Red Top, Heston. Their raison d'etre is to unearth sexually questionable vicars and GPs.
I mean, this is my reputation. It is not funny.
Am I laughing?
Right, I'm going to ring the editor. That snivelling shyster will rue the day that he ever set eyes on that Davis woman. I want an apology and a full retraction.
Good luck with that.
Don't be flippant, Daniel. We're working to advance the practice and they're working to... Well, make headlines turning him into Dr. Sex.
Hey! There are bins for that. It ain't rocket science. Red bins with a pics of a dog on them. These bins are for Cornetto wrappers and fag packets. Okay, you get me. Now put it in the right cussing bin!
I'm just trying to get my head around this. You're joining the army. You're joining the army and you've just told your mother over the phone.
I know how to handle my mum.
Over the phone?
Yeah, I know, but I need you to promise to keep it to yourself. Don't tell anyone, not yet, especially not Julia.
You've not told Julia?
No, I need to sort things with my mum and then I'll tell Julia. You know, I need some time to get myself together, so please, Ruth.
Okay.
Yeah, she'll be fine in a bit, my mum. I just need to give her some time to get
her head up.
Oh, Ruth, have you seen Michelle since I called you? Did she come here?
No, sorry, no.
But if you see her, please tell her to call me, would you?
Mm.
Thank you.
Of course, yeah, no worries. Bye.
Time for a tea break.
If I were you, I would make Julia something very soothing.
Beg your pardon?
Well, she was upset earlier, and that was before the reporter started phoning. I mean, I've stopped putting them through now, but she was on the phone to that PCT pillock for 15 minutes. Was that to do with you as well?
Leafy Leatherbridge is turning into Stalinist Russia.
Wait, second's out round two.
Oh,
is Michelle here? I mean, if she's the patient, I'll wait till she's free, but is she here? I need to talk to Michelle.
I'm sorry, I haven't seen her today.
She's got a day off, Vera.
But she's not at her house, and she's not at the campus, and she's not at that army place. So where is she?
Well, Michelle doesn't normally make a habit of coming in on her day off, Mrs. Corrigan.
Have you tried her home?
I said that. Is it true? Well, she told you. You know something about this, don't you?
Look, let's go and use my phone and see if we can track her down, yeah?
Why did you have to get her involved in all this stuff in the first place?
I'm on it. Julia, we'll talk later.
Did she do this when she was a kid? Hide herself away, wait for the dust to settle.
Hide from what? What's going on?
But she's not a kid, though, is she? She can't keep her head down and I'll get over it. She can't call me and tell me she's enlisting and then leave me to calm down.
Enlisting in what?
Like you don't know. She would never even have thought of this if you hadn't parceled her off to that place to do all that stuff with those soldiers.
Michelle is thinking of joining the army?
Stop pretending you don't know. Don't treat me like an idiot.
Oh, clear up, please. Shouting is not going to help.
What do you know about this? And I haven't even begun to shout.
Mrs. Corrigan, please.
My daughter is joining the army. Was it you? Were you the one who encouraged her?
Yes, but not to join up.
So it was you then? Tell me what you know.
Well, just that Michelle's work at Houseman is very important to her and she's been extremely involved
Did arrange for Michelle to take an attachment.
So you did start it! You started it!
Justin, could you give us a couple of minutes, please? Vera, look, just have a seat. Come on. Sit down. Stones in your eyes.
See the thorn. Did you know?
Not about joining up, no.
Then why would she do this? What's going on?
I'm lucky I'm a cripple. I'd have had you clamped if you'd had the use of your legs.
You have 6 new messages.
Michelle, it's your mother. Don't you think you can tell me that and then just leave me to calm down? I'm not calming down, do you?
I know you.
Meadows. Can you stop it, please?
You were with that nutter on the roof. Tried to chuck himself off. Tore the anti-pigeon strips off those elder pie over there.
Oh, yeah. Right. Yes, sorry, I didn't recognise you. Not in your uniform.
Hey, busy? Still trying to top himself.
I don't think it's appropriate to talk about it with you.
Locked up, I expect. I wouldn't want to talk about it either.
Actually, he's being looked after.
Banged up, you mean?
As far as I know, he's coping really...
As far as you know? The engagement off then, is it? You packed him up. Sensitive.
No, actually. Be finished with me. Now, if you don't mind, I think I'll walk.
Embarrassing.
Are you following me?
No, just walking in the same direction.
What was embarrassing?
Getting the elbow from a bloke in a straitjacket.
Mum.
You are joking, aren't you?
Look, just let me talk to you. I can make you understand.
Have you done it?
Yeah.
Then what on earth do you think we've got to talk about?
Go away. Stop following me.
I'm not following you. I'm just walking in the same direction.
I don't want to be followed.
I'm not following you. Got the afternoon off as it happens.
Are you hitting on me?
No.
Well, what are you doing here anyway when you work in town?
I've been redeployed.
Redeployed? Yeah, right.
The boss's daughter works in that office. The one your ex tried to chuck himself off before he dumped you.
Oh.
He's giving her boyfriend my job. They get to share their cappuccinos and the double chocolate muffins, and I get to troll around Leatherbridge campus, sort out dog muck and the crippled parking. Where are you going anyway?
I've got plans. I don't want to be followed. I'm going to miss the start of my film.
No, you won't. There's always 20 minutes of ads. I'll come with you.
What? What?
Why? You don't even know what I'm going to see.
Don't matter.
No, I'm seeing the new Twilight film. It's girly.
I've got an afternoon needs filling. I can get in touch with me gay side.
Mum, will you please sit down and listen to me?
I want some coffee.
You're making this really hard.
Me? You're the one who called and said you were joining the army and then put the phone down.
What? No, I didn't put the phone down. I told you I had to leave and I said goodbye.
Well, that's all right then. You're ready to talk, Michelle. Maybe I'm not ready to listen.
This is creepy. There must be something else that you should be doing.
No.
You're seriously going to gatecrash this film?
Yeah.
Seriously, this is seriously creepy.
Yeah, I've got nothing to worry about. The firm's accredited. Uniformed security guards are CRB'd.
These taxi drivers in Wolverhampton had the criminal records checked. Didn't stop them turning out to be drug dealers and rapists.
Oh, I sit next to you then. Sit somewhere else.
All right, yeah, because that won't make this afternoon even more weird. I can't stop you, can I?
If I wasn't your mother, I'd be telling you you're too old, you're not fit enough. You're desperate to be important. It's quite sad, really.
Thanks, Mum. I'm sure I hear all that.
But I am your mother, so I'm telling you, I'd rather you told me you were a lesbian than you were joining the army.
Why? Because the uniform's better.
Funny. You're turning 30. It's a hot flush. Tick tock, tick tock.
If you say so.
You, Michelle, in the army? I thought I'd brought you up better than that.
Okay, will you listen? Every day people are being blown up by IEDs. Every day military personnel and civilians are getting their legs blown off, and you brought me up to put other people first.
So what's that houseman place for?
In the army, I can get to them quicker. I'd be more useful. I want to help people whose lives have been shattered by this war.
And to think, you had new red wellies to go to Greenham Common.
What? Mum, I was a toddler and now you're just confusing the issue and... Anyway, we only went to that Greenham Common because you made friends with that woman from the playgroup.
Embrace the base.
Oh! Come here.
Oh, leave me, I'm fine. They shouldn't be there, these 16-year-olds.
That's not the point.
They haven't got the right equipment. They ain't got the right support. Not enough helicopters.
Radio 4.
Someone listen to the radio. It's always on the radio. They clear those landmines every day and at night the Taliban put them right back. They can't keep up, so they get blown up.
I know.
And do you know why they plant those bombs?
Mum, I would be useful there.
And do you know why we have to rescue those poor limbless babies as quickly as we can, even without the helicopters, because there aren't enough helicopters? It's because when the Taliban hear the explosions, they know where to go to with their guns. Not in my name, Michelle. That's what we chanted. Not in my name.
Mum, that was Iraq.
It's all fighting.
Okay, well, can I tell you what I know, please? IEDs.
Landmines. Call them what they are. You're not so daft you don't know they're still landmines.
Fine. They make these landmines so that when they explode, filth and debris is driven up into the wound. They fill them full of shrapnel and feces, human muck, Mum. So that they rip through flesh and blood and then they embed infection. Fighting that is my fight.
Not in my name, Michelle.
Half a quid change out of a fiver.
It's more at night. You turned your phone off?
Hey, got a phone. Well, this is vampires then.
And romance, yes.
It's finished by 4.
What are you going to do, work out how much it's costing per minute?
I only asked.
Yes, it's finished by 4.
Shoot 'em up, blow 'em up. Love a decent war film, mate. You can't beat a really good war film.
I thought you'd gone.
You know, I always cry when you cry. Don't you fancy a cup of tea?
In a bit. Listen. Has this got anything to do with that doctor who was in a wheelchair, the one who died?
Maybe. A little bit. He was a really good friend. I loved him. I still miss him.
What is it about you and blokes in wheelchairs?
I guess part of my decision is in honour of him.
Well, as joining the army, going to honour a dead doctor.
Mum, it's not just about that. It's complicated. It's about lots of things, but most importantly, it's about me and the person that I want to be.
You don't have to join the army to help wounded soldiers, Michelle. You're doing that already.
Yeah, but I can do more.
Has this business with Adam started up again?
What? You do know that I'm seeing someone, yeah?
You don't have to surround yourself with sweaty squaddies to meet a bloke who's not your half-brother.
Why are you being so horrible? Adam, Nick, finding a man, or I'm fat, desperate and ugly. Thanks, Mum.
And what makes you think you can suddenly start following orders? When did you ever do as you were told? Drills and assault courses don't make me laugh. Yes, sir, no, sir. Three bags full, sir. Really, Michelle? Do you think?
Oh, you can mock me, or you can dump your preconceptions and for once, listen to me and hear what I'm telling you, because I'm doing this either way, so do you want to take a minute to think about that?
Why would my daughter even consider joining up? During a war!
Because I'm a good nurse, Mum! I'm fast, and I think on my feet, and I'm calm under pressure, and that is because I am your daughter! And I have potential, and I can be better! And yeah, I've got no kids and no husband, but I have the chance to have a life that is more fulfilling. And I have it in me to... I know I can be brave. I just want to make you proud.
Don't think I'm proud of you as you are.
Yeah, well, maybe I'm not.
All right, so you don't have to be all Jonathan Ross about it, but you could at least tell me what you thought of the film. What's up with you?
Got to be somewhere.
Where?
Got to go to my flat, pick the dog up.
Right. Time for walkers, is it?
Are you walking her?
What kind of dog?
She's a Staffy. Before you start, she ain't vicious.
No, I love Staffies.
She's old. I don't mind cleaning up a mess, but the vet says she's in pain. Said she ain't happy. Said I ought to do the right thing by her.
The right thing?
She needs to put her into sleep. I made the appointment, I've got to go and get her.
Why haven't you said anything?
Why would I?
What have you been doing watching some daft film in the afternoon when you should have been at home with your dog?
Not that it's got anything to do with you, but me is very sensitive. If I'd have gone back home at a funny time and moped around, she'd have known. She'd have picked up something was wrong. I don't want to go back too early because I don't want her to work out what was going to happen.
Do you want me to come with you?
Why would you want to come with me?
But you shouldn't have to do this on your own.
Please yourself.
What would I do without you?
Just a bit of clearing up. You'll need a new coffee pot, though.
What would I do if you went and got yourself killed?
Mum, there's still training to do. I might not even cut the mustard.
You will.
Yeah, they might not even want me.
They're crying out for nurses.
I could get stationed anywhere. I could end up in a clinic just like Houseman.
But where does an army most need its trained medics?
Where the I'd... where the landmines are.
What would I do without you?
Funny, isn't it? I've been to the pictures the day I got her. Been to see Pulp Fiction. So come, I call them Mia. Because you're cuter than Emma Thurman, why you pup? Come on. Daddy don't mind carrying you.
toast. Nothing like toast to cheer us up. Hey, do you remember that time I had toothache and I was like, oh, I need some toast, and you said...
Oh, please, Michelle, don't start reminiscing about bad times made better by a piece of bloody toast!
I'm sorry this is causing you so much grief, but will you please tell me you understand why I'm doing it?
No, Michelle, I can't. How many mothers do you think said they understood and then stood in the rain at Wootton Bassett?
I'm not going to die.
You could get shot in the back of the head. You could get blown up. And it could be me when they say the family's been informed.
Mum, I'm not going to end up with my name on some memorial.
You don't know that. Who can know that? Nobody.
Wait here.
See, the difference is, I'm not drawn to people with bits missing like you are. I don't know where you got that from. If I'm honest, it makes me feel a bit sick.
Well, there must have been a strong wind the day this apple fell from the tree then.
What I'm saying is, I don't know how I'd cope if you came back with a stump.
I have a vocation. Sometimes I wish I didn't, but I do. It's not like I've got any choice.
Of course you do.
I've never felt so strongly about anything in my entire life.
What rubbish?
You think I've made some stupid snap decision, but you're wrong.
Am I? Am I, though? Because I can remember when you used to sneer at lads who left school and joined the army. Learn a trade, you said. What's that then? How to kill people?
Yeah, no, you're right. I did. I left school and I never heard from any of them again. Oh, hang on, except from Jonas Middleton. I saw him in the Icon once in his uniform. Still a right prat, I thought.
See?
Yeah, but they were nothing like the boys and men I've met at Houseman. I didn't know any women in the services at all. I've so much respect for them now, Mum.
Yeah, well, they're cheaper than helicopters. You'll be cheaper than a helicopter.
Oh, no, it's like a pamphlet.
You seem to think the only way you can make something of your life is by putting yourself in danger. You really want to take your vocation and be part of a war that'll go on forever?
We're seeing things differently.
Do you know how many occupying forces have been victorious in Afghanistan? None. Never. Not one. I heard that on the radio too. This mess will make Vietnam look like a picnic. I heard that on... Well, someone said that on the radio.
You know what? You spend way too much time ironing. I know, why don't we put on some Bob Dylan, shall
we? Don't be smart with me.
Can you at least try and understand?
It's no better than the First World War. They've just swapped mud for sand. And all this hearts and minds garbage is a smokescreen. Our army is an army of occupation and all of its members are targets. They're not cannon fodder anymore. That's not the right term. They're food for landmines.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, you're right. Literally, they put one foot wrong and boom, their lives are changed forever.
They shouldn't be there.
You know, I marched, I chanted, and I do the same thing today, except we are where we are and the damage is real and human. And my job is about repairing people's damage. You know that, Mum.
But you're my baby and you might die. And I only have one baby, and I don't want you to die. And I don't want you to end up in a wheelchair.
Will you please just give me a hug, Mum?
Oh, no! If I hug you, I'm telling you that it's all right to go. You see what you've done? You've made it so I can't even hold my own daughter. All your sisters want to fly. Around
my golden... Is she with some...
I live in the flat. I ain't got a garden. I ain't got a garden. I ain't got no 160 quid either. Have you got a garden? Yeah, well then. I only hope if ever you have to have your dog put down, you got the money to get her cremated on their own. So you don't have to leave in there with a bunch of other pov's dogs. Get off.
Sorry.
I ain't one of you nutters.
Wish there was something I could do.
Well, there ain't. Why would anyone want to do anything for me anyway?
Well, I'll see you around the campus. You should pop into the surgery, say hi.
I'll be working.
Isn't it? Yeah, well, my only daughter called and told me she was signing up. She'll probably save a lot of lives because she's a brilliant nurse, but she'll also be putting her own life at risk. So you see, some days call for a gin at R5.
With this room in. I was close to you. Please try.
This is me trying.
And this is me asking you to try harder because I'm not brave. I'm as scared as hell and I just need a hug from my mum. Please. Please, mum. Mum, please. Please, mum, I just want a hug. Please, Mom, please.
Sorry. Dr. Carter will be making
multiple statements.
Who's that?
No one.
A burglar?
Simon, I'm outside Dr. Diana's.
What?
A clinic, I know where it is.
I think we should call the police.
Police? Minute, please!
Actually, I wanted to see if you had a minute.
I think it might take a bit longer than that.
What's Kulagi Bawar Mikunima?
What's he saying?
He wanted to help him.
Me.
Trouble follows Jessica Fletcher.